You are looking at an amazing live shot from the Century Plaza Hotel and Spa on Burrard Street. Gorgeous sunshine today. One of our warmer weeks that we've had all summer. But we're joined by Brian Minter, horticulturalist extraordinaire. Brian, we're talking about transitioning our gardens to fall, to the next season. Make sure we have lots of colors, lots of texture as well. How do we do it?
Well, first of all, it's been quite a beautiful summer, but our annuals are getting tired, and it's the beginning of a new season right now. That's the beauty of gardening. We capture each season and take it to the next level. So instead of flowers that will fade and go, we use foliage, we use texture, we use color, and some of these beautiful planters you can see. And we talked earlier about the importance of berries, but also striking colors. And I would like to say that this year, the theme is black and white. There is no gray, right? It's all black and white, but yeah, and silver. Of course. And
but what do we have out there for flowers besides mums? We think, well, we have mums in the fall. And
We do.
And then other than that, what else do we have out there?
We have the beautiful ornamental kale, but new varieties that are stunning and unique and unusual. And as the color richens as we get cooler temperatures, they take on a life of their own. They're absolutely beautiful.
So it starts a little more green, and then the colors change as we get into the deeper fall.
The hot lights over here as well. And look at the foliage. This is a leucothe that's called curly and red because it's curly and red, which is gorgeous. The skimmia, and I have to say that the male skimmias are the ones that have the brilliant flowers on them, which attract pollinators in the spring, and of course grasses. Where would you be without grasses in everything fall? Which you can't have a container without grasses, because those are all the elements that create a wonderful fall look. So it's foliage, it's unique colors, and things that are perennial that come back year after year and stay with you right through until winter.
Okay, Brian, you mentioned the baskets, and you have a couple here, and they're well put together. How do we go about creating this ourselves, aside from just purchasing it from the store? Let's start with this one.
Truly, it's easy, and what I love about this, anything that's tall and thin is the look today. So you want that tall, narrow container, or a very low one as we have over here. And you need height. Height is the magic element here. We're using this beautiful golden cypress, which is tall and narrow, and we try and emulate it with this beautiful Kerokia from South Africa over here. And foliage plants like the Pierce with the long leaves on it.
So that's this one right here.
That's right, the Pierce japonica. And then you always have a bit of a focal point. I'm using this wonderful calocephalus called the silver bush as a beautiful plant, and then you accent that. And where you have something going up and an accent, you must spill down as well. That's where the grasses play such an important role. So you have this beautiful
actually
effect.
Spills over the container, whatever
it softens
you're using
it and gives you that look that you're hoping to transition into.
You also have some sticks in here. What about these guys? These are not alive,
we
correct?
We prefer twigs, but
sticks. Okay. Sorry, twigs.
And that's the other thing. In terms of white, what you actually do is you add that extra value by picking up colors. And the nice thing about the white twigs is they echo the silvers, they echo the whites, which is kind of important as well. And not only that, but Michael, as it starts to get dark in the evening, today we have beautiful LED lights over here that they last for the longest time. You intermingle the lights, so when it starts to get dark, your planter becomes alive.
It's alive in the evening after dark as well. We have to talk about this pumpkin in the display here. You told me you grow the pumpkins as well?
We do, because we're looking for special varieties, and this is a blue one, but it has a deep cavity in the center. We don't cut or carve the pumpkins. We leave them as they are, and then one of our wonderful ladies creates some beautiful tropical succulent gardens on the top. And as it gets colder, we'll switch over to some of the hardier succulents, but it gives you such a wonderful look. And Michael,
so that's not hollowed out in the middle.
Not at all.
The actual pumpkin itself has a concave top.
That's exactly what we're looking for something unique and different. And talk about an eye popper or a conversation piece on your patio or deck or your front door. These are absolutely amazing. And that's the exciting thing about fall color. We're going into a new season, and you look at some of the designer trends of using your silvers and your whites and your blacks. It adds a new element to it.
Amazing. Thank Absolutely you. Beautiful stuff. Brian, where do we find you? Your website quickly?
It's www.mintergardening.com.
Perfect. Thank you so much for coming in. It looks great. Stay with us. Coming up, more on Breakfast Television.
Do the next thing that you feel. We were so in vice.